What's up, everybody? My name is Brandon and welcome back to my channel. Today I am here to do another top five books that I want to read in 2020 within one specific category. I don't know what to name this series of videos, but I mean, that just sums up what it is. So I've already done the top five 2019 thrillers that I want to read, as well as the top five classics that I want to read in 2020. This video is going to be the top five BookTube YA favorites that I want to read in 2020. This is kind of holding myself accountable and reading these books that I've seen so many people talk amazing things about, but I just haven't read them yet. So this is me challenging myself to actually do that. So without further ado, let's hop into the books. The first book that I have is Scythe by Neil Schusterman. I have heard nothing but rave things about this book as well as the series as a whole. Even Jonathan has started reading this and been interested in it, and maybe this will be a book that him and I can read together this year. I think that would be really fun. But for those of you who don't know, this is based in the future where we as people have already figured out how to outlast death, and we are basically immortal, but overpopulation is a thing, and so they need people to die. So they hire scythes, and these scythes are the people who have to go around and kill other people, and they make the decisions, from what I can understand of the plot so far. They make the decisions on who lives and who dies, and there are a lot of politics that go into this and the problems, and I just think Neil Schusterman is like the king, or maybe not the king, but he's one of the YA authors who really goes above and beyond and makes people think about modern day issues within like dystopian like settings, and like he takes a modern day issue and like pushes it all the way in one direction. I hope to get to this soon. I've heard, like I said, amazing things. The next book I have, I am so excited about, and that is Red, White, and Royal Blue by Casey McQuiston. I have heard, again, nothing but amazing things about this, and it just sounds so cute, and it's an LGBTQ plus a romance novel, like, yes please. So basically, this is about the son of the president of the United States who has a rivalry with the Prince of Wales, I believe. It doesn't say on the back, but that's just what I heard, I think. So again, sorry, they kind of have this rivalry with one another, and so the tabloids have caught on to it and they are starting to create these nasty articles. And so the parents of these two boys are like, you need to get along with each other. So go on these like fake outings with each other and act like you're friendly. And so they start doing that, and it's a hate to love romance where they start to realize that they actually have deeper feelings for one another. So I'm excited to get to this. It sounds so cute and so fun. Yeah, I'm excited for this one. The next one I have is a YA BookTube classic, and it's one that was all over BookTube when I first started watching, like back when I was in middle and high school, and that is The Knife of Never Letting Go by Patrick Ness. I want to read this year because the movie with Tom Holland is coming out very soon, and I love Tom Holland as an actor, and I cannot wait to see him in this as the lead. I've wanted to read this book series for a long time because, like I said, everyone talks about how amazing it is. I just haven't done it yet. So basically, this is about a boy who lives in a town with all men, and they can hear each other's thoughts. They can even hear the thoughts of their animals, but he goes and wanders off from the town and finds a place where he can't hear anything, like any thoughts. And then he meets a girl and he can't hear her thoughts. And then again, madness ensues. He's like, why can't I hear your thoughts? His whole world is now becoming a lie, and he's trying to get to the bottom of what's really going on here. So I really hope to get to this soon. I've heard that it's incredible, and I cannot wait to watch the movie as well. The next book I have is probably the one I'm most excited about, and that is Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. I've heard amazing things about this being the LGBTQ plus equivalent of Harry Potter. So with that comparison, it just seems like it's gonna be amazing. So it's about a like school for paranormal entities, I guess, like a wizarding school, but also like the wizard's roommate is a vampire, and they have this like hate to love romance as well. They're like rivals, but then they end up loving each other, and it's this LGBTQ plus story, and I just, epic fantasy, maybe not epic fantasy, but fantasy, elements as well. So I can't wait to read this. I know I'm gonna fall in love with it. It's just a matter of me actually getting through it. And last but certainly not least, we have one that I've started but have not finished. I got, 130 pages in the last time I was reading it, and then I fell into a huge reading slump where I didn't read anything, so I put this book down. I was enjoying it so far, but that book is Six of Crows by Leigh Bardugo. I've heard amazing things about this. It's like fantasy meets Ocean's 11 is what I heard, as well as some LGBTQ plus elements on this one too, so notice a common theme. But regardless, they're making a Netflix series about the Grishaverse in 2020, I believe. So I want to watch that. And so in order for me to watch that, I need to finish these books. I read Shadow and Bone already. I have not read the rest of the original Grisha series, but I want to get through Six of Crows because I've heard it's amazing, and Crooked Kingdom as well. So I want to get through those this year. And I just love how beautiful this book is. Like I said, I've just heard amazing things and I want to get through it. So that's it. So these are the five YA BookTube favorites that I want to get through in 2020. I'm so excited about these. If you have read any of them, which I'm sure you have because you are not as far behind as I am, please let me know what you thought of them down in the comments below. And if you want to read these this year with me, then let me know that too, because I would love to have some buddy reads going on with some of these. I think it would be really cute and fun. But if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And also hit that post notification bell so you're notified every time that I post a new video. My name is Brandon, and I will see you all next time.